put a sheet over the chest so that I can't see it. But I know that it's still there. The chest is cavernous on the inside. My dictionary says that cavernous means full of hollow and empty areas. Devin's chest was cavernous. Devin and my dad had been building the chest for Devin's Eagle Scout project. He was going to build it so then all the other boys could learn how to build one too. It's the sheet that makes it look like a bird. It flutters up for a moment as if it's trying to fly. But I know that I'll never get anywhere. In this fictional account, we meet Caitlin, a 10-year-old girl diagnosed with Asperger's, who is coming to terms with the death of her beloved big brother, Devin. Death is something that we all face. However, when it stems from an arbitrary act of violence, such as a school shooting, coping delves deeper than just coming to terms. For Caitlin, her struggle with emotion is also intertwined with her battle with Asperger's, which only serves to constitute a more difficult journey for her. But through her journey, we're able to see that coping and finding closure delves deeper than just veiling emotion with a sheet. The Mockingbird, by Katherine Erskine. All of my teachers since kindergarten are here at Devin's memorial. She didn't even know Devin. Well, she went to two of his basketball games, but I've been to more than two of Devin's basketball games and the Lakers' basketball games, and you don't see me trying to help them. Shooters at Devin's school didn't listen much in English. Because they didn't understand the title of that book at all. I go and I sit down on the couch. And while I'm sitting there, I decide that I want to go inside Devin's room. So I go inside his room and I pick up one of his books, thinking that maybe I can squeeze some of the Devin-ness. I run out to the living room where my dad is, but then I see the chest. And I just start thinking about the day that our lives fell apart. That's what we call the day that we came back from the hospital without Devin. And I remember my dad, he picked up the books and he threw them on the ground and he picked up the sheet and put it over the chest. And I kept saying, no, 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 no. And when I shut my eyes, all I can hear are the doctors. There's nothing else that we could do. There's nothing else that we could do. There's nothing. We couldn't close Devin's chest. There's nothing. once we finished the chest. The principal said that we could have an unveiling ceremony. And so that day we walked into the gymnasium. I remember I had been here before. You see, that third step makes a really loud noise when you step on it, because Devin did so on his life ceremony. And I remember that I had screamed, and he jumped off the stage and he held me and said, Caitlin, it's going to be okay. And I said, no. And he held me and he said, Scout, I have to go now, but I can be right up there on stage and everything's going to be all right. Everybody's sitting down, so I sit down on top of my hands so I don't fidget. The principal welcomes everybody. Then he says, Devin Joseph Smith. And my dad gulps. And then the principal turns into a magician. She grabs the cape and the sheet covering, and she rips it off, and everybody starts